Hey guys, welcome back to Rogue Legacy. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Let's go ahead and pick our heir. Oh, look at her. And get this game started here. So we have Lady Shinoa and Archmage. Again, I don't really use them too much. I probably will one of these times, but maybe not now. I don't know. We got a knave. A tiny little knave, a little dwarf knave. Again, lacking peripheral vision. I should probably check. Oh god, Chun-Li the second is huge, isn't she? Super heavy and ginormous. Let's go ahead and play the... I guess we'll play Jenny. We need to play a dwarf, and we'll see what this no peripheral vision thing's all about. Now, last video, I made a whole incredible mess of money. Tremendous amount, at least for me at this stage of the game. I'm actually going to spend a lot of my money upgrading my stuff here before I actually upgrade my manor, which we are going to do. I picked up a few runes, in fact, maybe just one that I wasn't familiar with. Yeah, I want to see what this is about, the Grace rune. They scale slower, easier, but less rewards. Okay, so it just makes the game a little bit easier. I'm not bragging or anything, I'm just going to say I don't really feel like I need that, at least at this juncture, so we're going to skip that for now. And let's check out our items. I think, yeah, we got a silver helmet unlocked, right? Tremendous upgrade there, so let's go ahead and grab that and equip it. And then we actually have some armor. God, I did all that without armor. Madness. Alright, so now we have a set of armor, and I could increase my magic a little bit. I would need to increase my weight capacity if I wanted that, but we're not going to worry about that right now. And now I still have a ton of money, so let's go ahead and start upgrading and unlocking things. First, we're going to upgrade the barbarian here. In doing so, we will get a shout. Yeah, Faro Dust Shout that will knock pretty much everything back, enemies, and I think even most projectiles. What's over here? Oh, the Shinobi class. Yeah, Shinobis are great. So let's go ahead and get them too. Oh yeah, and we're getting a lot of stuff unlocked. And look at him! Oh, he just looks so cool. Dish out the pain, believe it. Now, this is a pretty neat thing. This is, I kind of briefly mentioned this earlier. But if you get this, you can actually keep a little bit of money when you enter the castle. Yeah, you can haggle with Charon there, and that's actually going to unlock an upgrade for our Shinobi class. The Hokage, I hope I'm pronouncing that properly. And we can also, oh, I love liches. Liches are great. So they start off with incredibly low HP, but every time they kill a guy, they actually gain more maximum hit points, so they become really powerful. Now, we are going to want a critical hit chance, like just a permanent passive crit chance is nice. Damage, yeah, we're going to want that, but not so much right now. And also getting our attack up is going to be nice. We're just going to kind of fill in all these empty spots. Magic damage up, eh, not so much, but yeah, why not? We'll go ahead and grab that. It didn't expand anything. I'm a little disappointed. Also, we can get a miner. This is another class for us to play as. When you're playing a miner, you actually accrue money much faster. Yeah. Ooh, but yeah, you really don't want to fight with those guys too much. They're a little bit weak. We can upgrade the knave. That's actually the class I'm playing now. Maybe I should. In miner, you can upgrade to have like a little lamp on their head. I really haven't found a use for it. If any of you know, feel free to let me know in the comments. I have no idea what it does. Oh, gold gain up is great too. Oh, I want that. Alright, let's go ahead and... do I upgrade the knave, or do I get my gold up? I could also upgrade the lich, which has an ability to max HP into max MP, just to swap those stats. Oh, I can't get that anyway, so... let's go ahead and just do this. We're gonna upgrade this guy. The knave is now upgraded. We're gonna get a lot more room in our manor. Yeah. We can slip past the enemy, so it makes us invisible, and we can actually, like, run through things, which is really nice. And then we're going to upgrade this class as well. Wow. With that one run, we have unlocked so much stuff. This is just crazy. Yeah, you can turn into a log at the last minute. It's pretty cool. I basically used it to just teleport around enemies. Like, I could teleport behind them. And we're just going to get this started. Sorry about the, you know, it's been almost 5 minutes. We haven't started yet. Let's get started. We're going to re-randomize. I'm up to level 18 now, and yeah, we still have that boss down. It's going to stay down. We can go into the boss room and loot the chests, I believe, but, oh, gotta watch that. But we can't actually fight the boss again and gain stats. It's a very sad thing. Is there? There's eyeballs below me. That's a little strange. Now, you know, exact opposite of being giant. If we are a dwarf, we have a much smaller hitbox, which is great. But unfortunately, I have to be a little bit more careful when I attack guys, because I gotta get a lot closer. So, you know, it works. I think, honestly, I prefer being a giant. Oh, that was stupid as hell. But, you know, this is still pretty nice. And, we're just gonna explore around here. We're gonna be able to tear through most of these guys. I still need to be careful, because, you know, I am by no means overpowered. Oh, shit. Yeah, see, I'm already taking massive damage in this room. See, I can turn invisible for a little bit. It does drain my mana, however. It's not just a nice little passive skill. Alright, keeping an eye on the paintings. Whenever they twitch at you like they have Parkinson's, you really gotta watch out, because they will definitely come alive and try and wreck your shit, man. But yeah, I plan to get to the forest. You know, we're gonna try and clear out floor one for a while still, because there's still money to be gained, and I honestly haven't really picked up many runes, and runes are... Oh, fuck, I missed that gold. And runes are definitely going to be in our best interest to collect, so just keep an eye out, guys. Being a dwarf is going to... Whoa, careful, buddy. A knight chestplate. Cool, upgraded armor. Is going to allow us to get to certain areas, given that, you know, the random generator feels like creating said areas. But there are certain chests and areas that you can only get to as a tiny dude. The tiny dude is very awesome indeed. Let's go ahead and get a little bit of this back. Is this the forest right here? It is. How do you pronounce that? Abkhazia. We'll just roll with that. I have a teleporter right next to it, so no worries. Now I can explore around, and as soon as I'm ready, we can just immediately head into there. Okay, carefully taking these. Wow, takes 3 hits. That's no good, man. Yeah, my damage is a little bit low. Not sure how I feel about that. The enemies do get stronger the more that I get stronger, so... Okay, let's just take a little bit of damage and turn invisible and try and sneak our way through. This is a toggle. It's like, it'll... The shadow will go away whenever... Wow, that cannon should have hit that thing. Whenever I attack an enemy, or if I hit the Y button again. So you gotta be careful, though, because your mana does continually dissipate the longer you are a shadow. Nice. So we're gonna get the nice boss loot, or the pre-boss loot, I should say. Unfortunately, we can't grind up on the boss. It sounded really weird. Not sure what I meant by that. But, you know, I probably could still take him. It would be a lot harder as a tiny dude, but, you know, it would be easier to dodge. Mainly, right now, the money is nice, but I'm kind of looking for fairy chests, I'm not going to lie. Because we're really going to need as many of those, seriously. I can't emphasize enough. I have this feeling that we're just going to need all of the runes. And we did miss a lot of recipes, too, so we really sped through this area and missed a lot of content. So, that's why I feel like, okay, is that level 3? You know, I don't even know. We'll figure it out. We need to find journals, because those give you hints as to what's going on. You know, it gives you backstory, but also tells you kind of generally where you should be heading at certain points in the game. Oh, we can change our scythe ability, which I don't know if I actually showed this off. I feel a little bit bad about it. The scythe throws tooth scythe blah, 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 like that. I can't talk. It's okay. Honestly, I prefer the axe a little bit more, so we're just going to roll with that. And check out our map. Okay, we still haven't explored a lot of the western area. Yeah, we're gonna do that. Again, we have the teleporter right next to the forest, so we won't be wasting too much time backtracking. I honestly wasn't paying attention at all there. I was looking at the chandeliers. Okay, let's just carefully almost fuck that up and get out of here. Nice. Vampirism again. Really helping me out tremendously in these runs. I gotta say, it is something I definitely appreciate. Get out away from the O-face painting there. Oh, I didn't take that one down. Yeah, critical hit chance, having a permanent passive critical hit chance, even at a lowly 2%, can actually really be of a, of great use to you. You'd be surprised. Yeah, that thing proc'd twice in this room alone. Granted, I think this character class has a higher chance to crit. Honestly, what's the plan here? The plan is we're just gonna get the fuck out. Wow, those guys were horrible. Shit! That means I'm really not gonna have much health to go into the forest area, but I don't really have a choice. We've actually fully explored level 1 already, so let's just get... Oh no, actually I missed an area down there. Okay, we'll explore a little bit more, which is good, because, you know, as long as I don't fuck this up, we can use this opportunity to get a little bit of health back from vampirism. Well, there you go, fucking it up. What did you guys expect? Seriously. Oh god, it hurts. Maybe using this down attack more. I have a hard time with the timing sometimes. Like, for me at this point, you know, with my skill level, it's somewhat unreliable, so I try to stay away from it as much as I can, but I need to get comfortable with it because I feel like it's something I'm really going to need to rely on later. I don't know, man. Alright. Really use a little bit of chicken. And are you guys seeing what this peripheral vision thing does? Like, I genuinely haven't noticed a difference. Granted, I haven't been looking. Honestly, I kind of forgot about it up until this point. Nothing really seems to be going on here. Oh, God. Wait, I can just go invisible. I can just go all the way down like that, right? Why am I going down? There's not a chest there. Well, there you go. That's an easy way to get rid of all of your mana. Good job, Alan. Good God. You know, I knew after having that great video yesterday, the next video was just going to be a complete debacle and wreck of a train. But, well, it was kind of unavoidable. Let's just put it that way. Okay, laser dude. Reminds me of Zero. Hey! That went pretty well. Again, that critical hit chance coming into play. Now let's just carefully work our way down. Yeah, skeletons really aren't too much to worry about. As long as you're paying attention to where their projectiles are, they won't really come at you too fast, so you can just kind of take your time here. Now we do have two more rooms still further to the south. I guess that this area does lead into the, what was it called? The Land of Darkness or whatever? So yeah, there would be more. Okay, careful. I saw that flail flailing around down there. Okay, hey there, zombie man. Nice. We have two paths to go here. I'm really surprised at the, double crit all the way across the castle. I'm really surprised at the lack of fairy chests going on here. There are a lot of fire dicks. God damn. Okay, whoa. Now, let's just casually, wait for them to stop attacking. Nice, we got one out of the way. You'd be surprised how quickly you get overwhelmed in this game. You really do. Just gotta be on your toes at all times. Looks like, though, are we at the end here? No, there's still a door down south. Okay. We got Ice Dude gonna try and flank me. The old flank and spank, but I'm not having it. You gotta be careful, too, with those eye guys. Because I don't know if you noticed, but their projectiles always shoot through, like, anything. So even if they're floors and floors below you, as long as they got a bead on you, they will continue to shoot that nasty-ass blood attack at you. Oh, some ceiling chicken. Freaking love ceiling chicken. You know, it's like Mitch Hedberg said, you know, things taste better if they fall. I know I'm butchering that joke, but, you know, it's talking about snack machines. And I can't tell a Mitch Hedberg joke. Let's just move on. Okay, there's the Land of Darkness. And with that, we have actually explored floor one. I missed an area under the boss. It's just a tiny room, so maybe we'll get lucky and find a nice little chest in here. Oh, there's a little chest. It's not a fabulous prize, but we'll definitely take it. My damage is pretty weak. Ah, that's not good, man. I got kind of spoiled earlier, I guess. Oh, God. Should I even bother taking those guys down and gaining the 4 HP? And the way I was playing, clearly, that would have been a poor... How am I missing all these rooms? Clearly, that would have been a poor decision. Oh, it's just right under the sturt. I told you guys in the first video, I'm going to be missing a lot of stuff. Doomvoss, are you shitting me right now? Are you totally pulling my dick right now? That was ridiculous. Well, at least we have more enemies. He didn't do too much damage. Gotta watch out for that spike floor. These fucking paintings are everywhere. It's super annoying. Okay, eyeball. And wah! Very thankful that that painting didn't come alive. That actually could have screwed me pretty hard, pretty easily. Story of my life, though. Whoop! Okay, and nice. Now, I'm curious as to what's going to be in this left room. There's also a lot of... Yeah, I know that painting's alive. There's also a lot of random chance rooms you can encounter. Like, I remember seeing one that had, like, a clown in it. It was really weird. And you can also encounter, like, giant paintings and all sorts of weird stuff. Like, tributes to other games that these guys have made. It's pretty neat. I found one with a jukebox one time. I know I'm spoiling them all, but fuck it. I feel like talking about it. And it played a little tune. It was really nice. Okay, cool. Wow, we got a nice recovery room, and we got a journal entry. Number 4 of the Prince's Journal. Everything about this castle is off. I can't seem to keep track of my headings, and there's no sun or stars to guide me. I find myself backtracking constantly, and I must painstakingly map out my progress, lest I go in circles. The maps I have pilfered off the corpses of other adventurers are breathtakingly inaccurate. It's almost as if they were describing a different castle altogether. Perhaps this place does something to the mind. Or are the stones truly shifting beneath my feet? Is that a mega turret, or is that just a regular one? That's just a regular one. There's a secret here. Yeah, I could have easily overlooked this. Discoloration on the ceiling, and you can actually notice a slight sparkle right there in the wall. Check this out. We go in here and hit up. Actually find a hidden chest with a sky rune. Huh. I think I know what that does, but we'll talk about that when I'm actually in the rune section. And I know proper. I think it's a pretty cool ability, though, and it's okay. And it's one that I'm definitely going to want to unlock. That was a tight move there. I'm pretty impressed with that, Alan. However, how are you going to handle it now? Ah, shit. You're going to scroll the enemies off screen. I find that when you're in a bad situation, that is really helpful, knowing that you can just leave the room and reset the enemies. I think their HP resets, but, you know, in the end, if you're getting trapped horrifically, well, it can definitely save your dick. I can't talk tonight at all. Alright. So, with that, finally, I know I've said it like 18 times now, but we have finally mapped out level 1, and we're going to continue onwards into the forest here. Just going to go up to that teleporter. Don't remember if there were any nasty traps on the way, so... Oh, wait, isn't this the, Yeah, this is the room right under the start room. Okay, I think I dispatched all the enemies in here. We've made a nice little chunk of change. Definitely not the, what the fuck was it, 6,000 or whatever that we had at the start of this video? But, you know, it'll do. It'll upgrade a few things. I kind of want to upgrade the increased gold find. I really like that. I just like gold in general, seriously. Alright, so now we're in the forest. Definitely can't fight the boss, especially, at least I feel, with my current skill set in this dwarf mode, where I'm super tiny. I feel like that fight, it would interest me to have a very wide arc in my attack so I can attack a lot of enemies at one time. And also, I really need to be able to take down those furies, the little eyeballs he spawns, as quickly as possible. And with the, the earth guy, with the relatively low damage of this character, I don't know, seems like a bad idea. You know what else seems like a bad idea? Trying to attack this guy, but somehow I got away with it. Okay, he's gonna try and summon his little earth spire at me. Yeah, I don't know if you noticed, I don't think I, accurately described it, but, a giant yellow magical circle will appear underneath your feet whenever he's about to attack you. So it is a predictable attack. Hey, Wolfhouse, how did that not hit him? Rewind there, I definitely attacked the guy. He must have, oh shit, still been invincible. This is how the story ends for us, isn't it? Invisible! Oh, no! Invisible! Oh shit, there are way too many. I just wanted the chest, but now, not so much. There we go. We got a healing font here. That's going to keep us in the game a little bit longer. However, I lack the abilities to get through here. Yeah, you can actually get multiple dash runes, which will enable you to dash multiple instances, even like in the air. So I'm assuming that's how you're going to want to get that one. I'm sure there are other ways, but at least with my limited knowledge of this game, that's the only way that I can think of at this juncture. So yeah, unfortunately, I'm not even going to bother looking at that any longer. We're just going to move on and carefully pay attention to everything around us. I'm trying to kill some guys, yeah, get a little bit of hit points back. Because we're not out of the game yet, and I'm actually very thankful that we at least made it to this room. Because we made a nice, like, 420 gold, was it? And we get healed up a little bit more. I could just suicide and fight the boss, but... Eh, we could make a little bit more money, yeah? Wow, what do you think the odds are of me getting hit here? And... There we go, okay. As long as you just time your dash out. There's no need to rush things, just don't freak out. Speaking of don't freak out... Okay, good. Spoiler alert, that has the potential of being a Doom boss. Yeah. I have one day. Development time, 1.5 months. Release date, April 15th, 2011. This is a message from the developers. Have you ever asked us of all of the game we made, which one would be our favorite? There would be a unanimous agreement with I have one day. As children, we were raised on the adventure game classics like King's Quest and Monkey Island, so this is really our homage to some of the best experiences we ever had in gaming. This game revolves around a meta-time puzzle where the player Just read it on your own. I'm done reading. This is ridiculous. Honestly, I tend to suck at games like those. You really won't see many of those on the channel. I don't know. I'm not a smart man, and solving puzzles and stuff like that, I've always found pretty difficult. I tend to just like, you know, watching others play it, truthfully. Alright, so mental note, Alan, we need to wrap this video up before you have to read it anymore. Okay, good call. Jesus Christ. Maybe I should have just went to the boss, I don't know. That was a pretty good run, though. Look at all those mobs we killed. Cool. Man, I already want to play some more. Alright, well, as always, thank you so much for watching, guys. And I will see you tomorrow when we will spend, you know, we have a small amount of money. And hopefully we get to try out some new character classes. We unlocked quite a few today, so we'll take a look. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you then.